Hi, Tokyo Tops! So today we're gonna talk about... What are we gonna talk about?
Companies,
Being
gay in a company in Japan and how that works.
So we actually both work here in Japan for several years already, right?
Yeah.
And also I know that before coming to Japan, you work in London.
Yes.
And in Canada as well.
Yeah.
Okay. So I actually work in Hawaii. Maybe you can talk about also like the differences like coming out in different countries as well.
So in my new department, I'm like half out. So in my old department, I was fully out.
Okay.
And then I switched departments last year. And my thing at the moment is kind of like, if you ask me, I'll tell you. But I'm not going around with my pride flag going like, I'm here, I'm queer. One cool thing about my department is I actually ran into someone who used to work in the department. And he was like, and he happens to be gay as well. And he was like, oh yeah, everyone was totally fine. And everyone knew. And so there was absolutely, so I know at least when the story comes out in my new department and everyone knows, I know it's not going to be an issue, which is great.
Yeah, I'm fully out. In my both current company and also previous company and also the company before, I've changed jobs like 3 times. But people realize very quickly because I'm not the most masculine acting person, you know? But I told them I was bi in my very first job. Because I feel like it's easier, a gay way that...
Bi now, gay later.
Bi now, gay later.
The really cool thing about my company is we get these sort of not courses, but internet mails that we have to go through and actually have to like sign things and read things. And it's usually on diversity. So it's about, you know, like treating everyone in the workplace equally, regardless of gender or sexuality and stuff like that. So every time I send it, I'm thankful that they are making everyone aware in the company. Like, everyone knows that this is an initiative. They have to, because they have to go through all the work and sign it at the end and send it. And they've supported Pride. They've sponsored certain things in Pride.
Right.
And the other offices around the world are all their, like, diversity and, you know, gay rights and stuff like that.
Because I work in a very international American company. So, like, just like your company, we also have lots of, like, workshop or online training that to understand discrimination, harassment, understand diversity within a collaborated, you know, company's environment. So all of the new hires, when they join the company, it's mandatory to take those trainings. So I'm very grateful for it. And also just because I'm so open to everyone, I got the opportunity to be on the cover of our company's brochures when they...
It's great.
Yeah, when they try to like hire new people, attract new talents. So I'm on the in the pamphlet and
they're
saying,
like, look at all these gays, come work.
I feel it's also easier when you're in a foreign country. It's much easier for you to come out. Like, if I'm in China, it will be more difficult for me to come out, just because I have to care about my family's feeling and also my. It's a lot of people that I need to protect and necessarily just do things for myself. You know?
As great as Japan has been, and I have felt accepted and it's not that big of a deal, it's still a bigger deal than it was both in England and Canada.
Like, a bigger deal as
to be gay.
To be.
Like, it's so much easier to be gay
in
a company in England, the most in England, and then second Canada. I would, after work, some guys would come up, straight guys would come up to me and be like, oh, hey, like, Andy, what are you doing?
You want to
go for a drink?
Ass?
Well, they'd be like, want to go for a drink? And I'm like, actually, I'm just about to head down to the gay area,
okay,
which was a couple blocks away for a drink.
Okay.
And at that point, in Canada, the guys would be like, cool, have a nice time.
Okay.
In England, they were like, can we come? And I was like,
Are you sure?
Are you sure? And then and then they came, and we would go out to the gay area together all the time.
Okay.
There were always, I've never had my straight male coworkers ask me, sit down and be like, hey, how's that guy you're seeing? Have you had any good dates lately? Like, they were talking to me like my girlfriends would.
I had an English manager before, And he always like invited me and my ex-boyfriend to his house to have like dinners and stuff. And he would ask me lots of my personal relationship stuff. Maybe it's the English
thing. It's Europe. It's a British thing.
It
was so refreshing and so lovely. And that, of course, we can't do in Japan either. So for me, Japan is good, but I'm never going to have these conversations. That's an interesting thing though, right? Is you feel for whatever reason a benefit by being here.
I don't think there's anything I ever like holding me back. Yeah. And just let me say like I'm not.
But
okay.
I feel I'm more held back here.
Okay. So like to me, but one of the thing is I feel like my Japanese colleagues sometimes they feel a little bit pressured that they cannot come out. Even though the company itself has policies, have protection, promoting equal rights to other employees.
Yeah.
But I feel like as a native Japanese employee, I don't know, like they just got some like mysterious like pressure. They still don't feel comfortable to come out.
I said before, my company they supported Pride last year. And my friend, my coworker, who is mainly spearheading it with HR and stuff like that, he would sometimes invite me to the HR meetings and I would go and they knew I was gay and everything as well. And so we were working with that team to get everything together for Pride. What sort of thing would be good? What would be a good way to represent the company? What do the gays want to see?
Right.
So we were able to do a lot of cool stuff. But even on our floor, we knew all these people and no one wanted to be out. They didn't want to do the march. They didn't want to be in the parade because
they don't want to be seen.
They don't want to be seen. And it was really difficult because the whole point of sponsoring, you know, part of Pride for my company was to show we are diverse and like we're accepting. But if you only have two foreign gays.
And they're gonna, you know, just say because they're foreigners. They
exactly. Coming to Tokyo Pride, it's all just a bunch of companies that are advertising, come work for us, we're open, we like love diversity, stuff like that. I think focusing on a foreign company is probably more likely, not entirely, but more likely to be accepting of that.
That's true, but I also think there are a growing number of Japanese companies are doing the same thing. Mm-hmm. And actually, we're gonna post a link down below because I have actually personally joined those events before, not as to represent my company, you know. So I have been those like hiring events to represent, you know, the LGBT in my company and talk to people how it is the working environment. ETC, right? I feel like it's a trend right now. I don't want to say like being homosexual is a trend, but I think it is a trend that a lot of companies that are working on their HR department to have those like training programs or go to those events to attract like important talents because gay people are very talented.
Very talented.
Just be yourself. Like I work in a Japanese company, they didn't have an LGBT supporting group. If you don't hold yourself back, probably nothing's gonna happen to you. I would say Japan's in general pretty safe.
I think you're already different as a foreigner. There is a added, for better or for worse, there is a acceptance that you are gonna be different from the
They have a different
common
expectation.
Japanese. Yeah, exactly. So when you come out as gay, it's going to be probably less shocking than a Japanese coworker. So let us know what you think. If you have any questions, there's a lot obviously to cover in this topic. So if there's something that we haven't talked about that you'd like to know, let us know in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe.
Thank you.
Bye.